Happy 108 followers!
It's the special Buddhist edition, yeah. Instead of the 100 follower special.
Yeah, we have 108 followers. We have the same amount of followers as there are Buddhist sins.
Is it sins? Is that what it is? I thought it was virtues. Maybe it's both.
No, it's 38 virtue. Or
36?
36 virtue.
It's like 36 paths. Times 6, or something, is 108.
36 chambers of the Wu-Tang Clan.
What's 108 divided by 3? It's 34?
34.
No, I think it is 36, actually. Yeah, it's 36.
Okay.
Then you divide that by 3, and it's 12. So it's 12 times 9.
Can we go on a jungle adventure now?
Okay, let's go on a jungle adventure.
Feel like
that's the best part of Buddhism, though, is math.
Yeah, Buddhists are really good mathematicians. That's how the stereotype goes, isn't it?
I guess because Buddhism is big in Asia.
Yeah.
It's kind of getting its feet everywhere now, though.
Yeah. Well, because it's the chill religion.
Yeah. Like,
My dad doesn't even consider it a religion.
Like the chill, Gamecube music.
So my dad, Mr. Friction, he was on stream once, and,
He was?
Yes, and he has a hatred of religion.
Yeah.
The dude just won't tolerate it. Like, that's the thing is that he believes in God, but he just hates religion.
Yeah.
Because he thinks of it as, like, a method to just control the populace by exploiting their beliefs. And I'm like, that's kind of tragic in a way.
Okay, that's a good volume.
But no, even he doesn't consider Buddhism religion.
Yeah, it doesn't have a lot of the standard things that a lot of other religions have. Okay, I think we checked with Sparkle Star Guy last time. Dazzle. Oh yeah, we did.
It's like Buddhism doesn't, like, preach, oh, you gotta kill all the homosexuals.
No, or, like, it doesn't preach that you have to try to convert all the non-Buddhists.
And because one of its core tenets is that all of life's sufferings come from want. And I'm like, that is real, that is the realest thing I've ever heard come out of a supposed monk's mouth.
And it's also all about tolerance of other religions specifically.
Like, yeah!
Buddhists are allowed and encouraged to celebrate other religious holidays with those religious people.
Yeah, because they're chill dudes!
Yeah. Are we Buddhists?
No. Like, we're too corrupt to be Buddhists.
Yeah, they wouldn't allow us.
We have so many worldly pleasures, dude.
Please get out of our monastery.
We play video games for God's sake. Anyway.
You are not welcome here.
I'm sure they... Buddhists love the bull, apparently, though. There's
the bull?
Bowling, yeah.
Bowling? What?
Apparently, no. So,
you lost me. Is that the hip new drug these days?
Bowling!
Oh, bowling.
You know, like throwing a fucking ball down a lane?
I kept hearing bull, B-U-L-L.
Bull?
Like, are they matadors?
They inject bull testosterone directly in their eyeballs.
Yeah, sure. That's how you attain enlightenment. So, right. Mario...
It's not a Mario stream if we're not talking about
something.
Anything but Mario.
Yeah.
Well, the religion in this game, they worship stars. And religion in this game is actually verified because the gods in this game and in this universe in general actively talk to everybody who lives in this world.
Yeah. We come back to a religion specifically a lot in Mario games for some reason.
Well, because the concept of religion in the Mario universe is fascinating because... There doesn't seem to be one.
But at the same time, there is kind of one.
It's low level. It's low key. It's not like there's a pope, like, influencing the course of, like...
The Mario Pope.
The wizard.
I guess, yeah, I guess Merlin is kind of the star pope.
Yeah. What?
What?
Is that what's written in Princess Peach's email?
Yes!
The legendary treasure is actually the spirit of an ancient demon! Those fiends want to use the power of the crystal stars to resurrect it! How bone chilling.
What have you found out,
like,
Professor?
Checks out! It matches what I found!
And you there, in front of the TV, you listen up too.
Oh no, the fourth wall has come down.
Are you talking to no one?
Pinkie Pie was like, oh, oh, oh!
You know, like 20 years from now, that will be relevant when no one's watching on TVs and we're all on hollow screens.
The crystal stars were created by this monster. And it tried to use them to control the world. As one does.
They probably some called something else like hollow television or something.
Yeah.
You can't, like, not call it a TV.
Hey, if you're watching this 20 years in the future...
Why?!
First, why? Secondly, can you use your time machine, come back, and tell us what it's like? That'd be cool.
Yeah. We say that, then we
Does anyone think it might be better just destroy them?
Well, that was my first thought, too.
We can't do that. There's a slight possibility that the thousand-year door is weakening.
It holds the power to seal the beast. I don't know why, because it made them, but...
1,000 years! I guess that's how long the magic lasts.
Yeah.
I guess that's why they call it the 1,000-year door after 1,000 years. Uh-oh.
We must be ready for the demon's return, even if they fail. So I guess we'd have to, like, re-enchant the stars in order to seal it again.
You gotta return all the elements back to the tree so that the tree will live on and resist the like, jungle's evil influence.
Yeah, or we have to get all the, we have to get all the demon cheese. You know, reset them into the artifacts.
gotta find all the masks, all scattered across the world and gather them back up. Put them where we gathered all the other talismans that were scattered throughout the world.
I wasn't paying attention. What the fuck are we doing?
We're going to the fucking island.
We're going to the harbor. We gotta ask around the harbor. What's our? She's ultra rank. She's super rank. I think we've upranked everyone we can for now.
Yeah. So we must press on.
Dragon.
Whee! Speed run.
So I think that that one spike room is the only thing we can use Vivian for.
Yeah.
She's not much of a field partner.
No, she just hides. That's it.
What's our coins like? 86. Kinda low. What do you got for me, mustache man?
Of course. Earthquake, stopwatch. What's the stopwatch do?
It's an item.
Oh.
Stuns. The only badge is timing tutor.
Learn the timing for stylish commands. No?
We can't afford it.
Oh. Wait, we have 86. I thought that was like...
It was 120.
Oh. I must have missed
it. Hey, Luigi. Nice mechanic.
You wrecked my go-kart.
You're gonna pay me back, Ketchum. What was it we were watching?
In the meantime, fuck me.
I think we were watching Code Lyoko, and William said he was in a go-kart club, right?
Yeah, he apparently raced go-karts like a badass.
That's awesome. I wish I had a go-kart club in middle school.
They're fun to race. I've raced on one before. They're really fun. They're like tiny cars.
Yeah, I've been on go-karts. I've been on normal tracks, and there was one track that was a drifting track. It was just a circle, and they were constantly spraying it with water. Oh. And it was exactly like Mario Kart.
Oh my gosh.
It got very realistic drifting.
That's so cool.
Oh, it's like the Pokeball symbol. It tells you which badges you already have.
Nice.
Oh no, this is selling. Never mind.
Oh, the thing you have is like, like what you have equipped. Oh, there's the simplifier and the unsimplifier.
Head rattle might be worth it.
You might need the simplifier to improve your timing.
Okay, what are your... What are your deals?
You get it? I'm insulting you.
I get it.
I'm insulting the TV, too.
Oh, I can buy Power Rush here. That'll be useful in the future.
Yeah, when you go to fucking every hit counts mode.
I don't need to worry about these yet. Maybe head rattle. Nah.
What's head rattle do? You hit him and they are stunned?
Confused.
Okay.
Which I think means attacks might miss. If it works.
Dizzy is attacks might miss. Confused is traditionally you might hit yourself or your own team member.
This isn't conspicuous.
Oh, that's a really nice ship.
Very colorful. Too colorful.
Is this yours?
Got something to say?
Keelhaul Key. You don't want to go there.
I got no need for a curse from the Pirate King.
What?
Gold Roger?
Curse of the Wow. Dude, talk to that other pirate. Not him. Him. You look like you're a badass. Yeah.
There's got to be a way to just go poof and get rich, you know? Poof!
I'm looking for that too. Oh, you don't give a shit, huh?
Nope. Fuck it, let's go drink.
Where are you going for a drink?
Hey. I'ma get the fucked up!
Hey, you wanna buy some death sticks?
Huh?
Nothing. It is an episode 2 reference. Star Wars. And what do you want?
I am called Flavio. I am, how you say, a trader. The richest man in Rogueport.
What species are you? I've been
Next question.
I've been watching you, and I'm trying to figure that shit out. You got yellow skin and purple hair, but you got a mouth, which means you're not like a fucking, like, dude from the fucking Sunset Games.
He's a Muppet. What is missing from my life?
You're,
I must know. Romance. Emotion. Thrills. Money, maybe?
Emotion.
You're the flattest person I've ever seen. The gradual process that forever alters the landscape of life like rain on dirt.
God, foolish Flavio.
Not erosion, you silly man. What I need is emotion.
That's it.
I thought he was just being poetic at first.
Yeah.
Oh, Cortez the Pirate King. Fuck Gold Roger.
Cortez. Apparently he was such a good pirate, he traversed dimensions.
Oh, yeah.
Because he actually exists in real life.
Yeah. Not as a giant, like, kaiju skull.
No, he was, he just,
We don't know that yet.
Yeah, he just killed a bunch of, native Mexicans and then stole their gold.
Wasn't there also a Cortez in One Piece? If there's not, I'm sure we'll run into one.
God, why hasn't there been anybody called Cortez yet? I guess Diaz Drake is the closest we got.
Yeah, I was thinking he was like one of the supernovas, was a Cortez, but maybe not.
No, you're thinking of Diaz Drake.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
Cross Drake.
X Drake. Well, good, he should have been just X Drake. Why the fuck you call him X and then say Diaz?
No, it wasn't. Was it Diaz? Diaz Drake?
Yeah, they called him Diaz Drake.
Oh, okay.
For some reason, like, X. Oh, yeah, when I see an X, I think of Diaz.
Yeah.
So there's this pro wrestler called Shelton Benjamin, and when he got to New Japan, he needed to change his name, so he just put a Diaz in the middle. Oh, I'm sorry, it wasn't Diaz. It was fucking X, you stupid fucking game!
You know, Professor D'Xavier.
Oh, wait, no, why am I blaming the game? It was X, you stupid fucking series! But I like...
Are you insulting Oda-sama? Oda?
Sorry.
Oda-sensei?
Sorry, Oda-sensei. So, my apologies, forgive me.
Yes, his penis stretches.
Alright, let's go.
Oh!
Oh no, problem.
Wait a minute. What's our crew? We have two toads, the captain, us and our gang, a pirate dude, and...
Guy in a bandana. Dr. Eggman?
Hmm.
I think that's Dr. Eggman. He's in a disguise.
Dr. Eggman in a disguise. Like...
We need a navigator. An absurdly skilled navigator.
I have a solution.
Pa-patch. Get it? Like ba-bomb.
Patch. Bang. Ba-bang. Ba-ba-bang.
There's a legendary sailor in Rogueport. Oh, Captain Bobbery.
Sure, why not? You haven't said a fucking word this entire time, Bandana Man.
My captain will handle all negotiations.
Come to think of it, who repped you again?
Oh, okay, Mario's the captain.
Where did you say you were from? Wait, Mario's the captain?
I guess so.
That's what a reputation does for you. I'd love to see just like John Wick just go on a boat that everybody notices he's John Wick and they say, you could be Captain John Wick. He's just like, okay.
Hey, Eggman, can I have your autograph?
Yeah, I'm pleased to meet your acquaintance.
Yeah.
Wow, Eggman, that's a funny laugh you've got.
By the way, how's Sonic?
Oh, that blasted hedgehog!
Not that irritating hedgehog again.
Did they ever... Shit, that bastard Sonic!
God damn! Thank you.
Best subtitles.
Thank you, come again.
I just would love to find like a script and just make it more vulgar and obscene.
Just for the sake of it.
Yeah. Like if Backtrack of the West just took a script and made it English, I'd just love to take that and just make it darker, edgier, and just with the subtitles.
Take Powerpuff Girls classic and make it South Park.
Ah, fuck you, you stupid blonde!
Hey, Mojo Jojo, we'll get right up in that ass.
Mojo Jojo. Now, because he speaks, is it bestiality?
Miss Bellum not only doesn't have a face, anytime she's on camera, it's just her tits.
That's basically her character in original South, like, Powerpuff Girls.
Just hourglass body and that's it.
Hourglass body.
He told me to leave, so I went into his bedroom and stole his shine sprite.
I'm stealing your shit! Okay, fine, just get out.
You seek Admiral Bobbery? Take your search elsewhere.
And then, what do? You just leave for a bit and you come back?
Well, time to do what I always do when I'm lost and confused.
You know, like, people seeking other people's help is like,
I'm gonna get fucked up!
And in China, there's like the, during the Rise of the Three Kingdoms, like shit, whether, however it was real or fake, there was like this guy who was seeking the help of a famous strategist called Zhu Ge Liang. And like, he sought him once and he wasn't there at his place. So he came back the next day and still wasn't there. So he was like left. And then he finally came back home. He came back to him. He's like, I need your help. And you're like, you came to me 3 times looking for my help? Of course you could have my help.
Yeah.
I'm honored. It's like, this famous lord visited me 3 times? Fuck yeah.
Admiral Bobbery? I know him. You know that house just past the wall in the east part? That's his.
Oh, that's what you need to trigger the flag that'll allow you to recruit him?
Yeah. This would be obtuse as fuck if we didn't know what we were doing. I think I had to look this up my first time.
Yeah, like, his secrets broke.
Be better off if you just let him be.
Like, if you know what you should be, if you know what you're doing and you try to, like, sequence break at certain points, then you should be rewarded for it. Not like, oh, you actually gotta speak to the bartender.
Yeah.
And although, you should still have the bartender there, because if you don't know what you're doing, it'd be pretty nice to have a direction.
Yeah. Like, it would make sense if you came to the bartender for more stuff in the game, like, he was your go-to, like, frankly. But this is the only time you have to talk to him. Oh, this isn't the place.
Oh yeah, the info board. Cool. We have confirmation from the fucking bar man.
Drop the axe, Super Stash. We already found out that you're Admiral Bobbery.
Yeah.
Poppycock.
Tell me.
What would you want with me if I were this chap?
I need a navigator. You'll have to look elsewhere. I can't...
I shall set sail upon the sea, nevermore.
It's like Mako Tsunami. I love the sea, but I hate the sea!
I love to hate the sea.
And I hate to love the sea.
Umi no baka!
That's great.
Fuck the sea.
Alright.
What's the next move, Chief? The salty dude is going nowhere fast.
He is salty!
Yoshi, but with the voice of Drago. Dude, bro, Shenron.
Dude, bro, Shenron.
We're finally up to season 5 of Jackie Chan Adventures.
That's a fucking crazy ass shit. Just like the second episode of that season, he was like such a loser. He paid for it. He either hitched a ride on a cruise disguised in like this robe, or he even worse, paid for a ticket.
Yeah, we had the. Hold on, we gotta go through this first.
Yeah.
Won't go on the sea, huh? You really need Bobbery, huh? Alright,
His tale's sad. Horribly sad, actually. You'll probably end up crying. No, I don't like sad stories. I can take it.
Play the sad music. No?
He had a wife of enduring beauty named Scarlet. The two of them were madly in love, the kind for fairy tales.
He was a renowned sailor. He came back.
Scarlet never complained, and he always waited faithfully for Bobbery's return. His eye never drifted. He loved only Scarlet. So they lived and found happiness where they could, and all was good. For
until
a time. And then Bobbery got sick, and they had to skewer Scarlet.
A passing cold, but it turned too serious. At sea.
He was long at sea and did not know his wife was dying.
Oh, and
she
then
died.
She died.
And he blamed the sea because he was at sea. Tragic.
You're a fucking idiot. You just stay with your wife. This shit happens. You couldn't have known.
What a downer. Yes.
We have no choice. If we don't, a demon will come. Didn't you notice the muddy water? Dude.
Yeah. Muddy water and,
demons are afoot. Muddy water, the toast is falling jelly side down.
Need to get the child of light and shadow.
El Diablo.
Alright, we got a letter.
One more stream and Lagoon's finished.
We got a letter from his dead wife that we can bring to him.
Wait, they hid his letter from his dead wife? Why?
You know, I just never had the courage to give it to him.
How you holding up, Bobbery? I keep asking myself, why her? What are you really doing here? Just checking up on an old friend.
Oh, not by Blabberton's beard, not you again.
Yeah, sorry about the Russians who stole your boat and killed your dog. You want to take revenge on them with us?
There it is.
My love, if you're reading this letter, then I'm dead.
Because fate has stepped between us, I've decided to write you this letter. I must have passed away while you're out to sea. I must imagine you will blame yourself for it. My life was short, but you gave me more than a lifetime's worth of joy. Though you will mourn, I beg that you remember that time, like love is a tide. Sea puns. You are one with the sea, as you are one with me. Do not lose both your life's loves. Don't hate the sea, Bobbery. Gee, that would have been a nice letter to have years ago, before the years of hermitage.
The sea was the only thing that allowed me to live. My comfort, my days alone grieving, and you took that from me. People have been asking me if I've been back. Well, up until today, I haven't made a decision. But yeah, I'm thinking I'm back. So you can either give me the sea, or you'll die screaming beside it!
Wrestling shtick?
No, John Wick.
Oh. John Wick 2?
No, original John Wick.
Oh, I don't remember.
You remember the one where he's tied up to the chair and he's ranting at the Russian dude? Like, give me your son, he killed my dog. It was just a dog. It wasn't just a dog, it was a dog for my dead wife. But the Russian dude's like, oh fuck, we fucked up.
Yeah. I remember being tied to the chair. I didn't remember the details of the speech, no. Oh, I don't have him in my party yet. I can't blow stuff up.
No. He's joined as, like, a navigator. He hasn't officially joined you.
Yeah.
He's got his own union to go through.
Alright. Let's get stranded.
Alright. Dropped in an island, lost at sea. Shipwrecked you'll cease to be. Should play some pirate shanties for this.
That's shove off. Oh, steel drums.
Yeah.
They were practicing for the Mario Sunshine soundtrack.
Where's the remote?
Doesn't matter. It's on surround, remember?
I can just mute it and then,
No, you can't.
Oh, I can't. Whatever. Oh!
X-Not Black is on board vessel.
We have been infiltrated!
But how?
Why? How could this happen to me?
That speech you gave is absolutely gonna peak.
The key to pirates.
I've been louder before and it didn't peak.
Oh, it peaked.
You sure?
Yeah.
Alright.
Well, we now have a date format for the Marioverse.
The star months on the XO day.
That has to be the first month, right? Because it's the stars?
Yeah, what's the second month? Mushroom. Third month is flower. Fourth month is coin.
Day XX.
XOXO. You think, like their numbering system is binary? No, it can't be, because they charge, like, 100 coins and stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, it's the note day!
My favorite.
Sing shanties. Skull Captain Cassie's Glee, Stash Brothers' Best of Friends.
Three times Red Stash lands on his end.
What kind of shanty is this? Blue Stash's belly four times as wax, so let's hear those fireworks go. That doesn't even rhyme!
Nope.
Maybe it didn't in Japanese, I don't know.
Maybe.
Hey, Ted Woolsey, you think you can translate this? Oh, he's been fired. Oh, let's get this other dude.
Reads like instructions. There I was, locked in deadly combat with a sea serpent. Oh, here he goes, Usopp.
That's fine. You always have. It's always good to have an Usopp on the crew.
He does have the nose.
Yeah.
Oh, spooky music. Awful sorry to interrupt that wicked story, but the ship stopped.
What? Oh, you're right.
Well, it's your job to keep it moving, right?
But if it stopped, there's either no wind or somebody's dropped the anchor. What the fuck?
Cool teleportation you're doing there.
Oh no! Yeah, well, I'm working on it. Just wait a Goomba stomping moment.
You scallywags!
There was nobody there!
That white hand on your shoulder, it's just imaginary.
But who was phone? One day you were locked adrift at sea because your ship was destroyed. Then you see the other boat come by you, so you decide to hitchhike. And then the boat goes ahead and stops at you. When you drift to there and climb aboard, a skeleton pops out.
Is that from something?
Yeah.
Oh. We're surrounded!
Then a skeleton popped out.
Move the boat! Oh shit.
So they were attacked by a bunch of fucking ghosts.
Nah, I can take them all.
Mario's just kind of wait there flapping his arms. Trying to fly away.
I saw a truck today that had the license plate YARG.
I thought you said you saw Trump.
No.
For a second. Oh, YARG?
Yeah.
That's great. God. What we need right now is a good pirate robot.
Yeah.
Timbers. Oh, it's X Star. Oh, so.
Okay, so the formats are 0, X, Note, Star. Those are the four numbers in sequence
so
that we
know.
So
this is day 14 on the fourth month. So this is April 14th.
OX. So 24th?
Well, because X can't be higher than 2.
No, it's 2.
Yeah.
Why can't it be higher than 2?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
It can't be lower than 2.
Okay, so it's the 24th day of the fourth month.
Yeah, sure.
All right.
Math!
We figured out your dating system. Oh!
Heart, day 25. We've made a semblance of civilized life here. The ship's flotsam walked in, and now we have salty bread and other salty things.
Oh, wait. What?
So, it's in series of 5. Is that a different...
Wait a minute! What? What? X, you're...
X came after O.
Oh, god damn it! Yeah! God damn it!
So the tens field goes backwards, but the ones field goes
what
forwards.
What the fuck am I looking at? No, they must have lost count.
Yeah. 3 days on the Isle now. No, they're still going in sequence.
Is it counting down?
Oh, did it say it was a new month? I didn't pay attention.
No, it didn't. I wasn't paying attention either, though, so I don't know.
We finished a wee hut for you to rest in.
Yep.
I don't think they're gonna hear that very well.
Yeah, you're right. Dang it!
What one was that? That's Shipwrecked, isn't it?
Shipwrecked. Yeah. Let me just get to the...
They're not gonna hear it at all.
Wackadoo! Not again!
Now it's gonna be loud, I can see the levels.
Yeah. He said they couldn't hear it, so I had to fix that!
Yeah.
Alright.
We'll leave him for now.
Did we kill him last time?
I don't remember.
Like, no, in Paper Mario, did we kill the wackadoo?
Oh, no, we didn't. They're in a huge fight, because this is the time for that.
What, you saw all those ghosts, you turned to jelly.
What are you talking about? You're the one quaking in his boots, fancy pants. Wait one moment. Did you just call the great Flavio fancy pants?
Thank you.
You little cyclops.
And suddenly ghosts. And then a ghost jumped out.
And then a skeleton popped out. You are squatters.
Me? Yeah, they don't want us squatting on the island.
Oh, hey.
That's nice.
That's good. Just use your strongest move.
I didn't fill my HP. I also don't have...
No, it makes sense, because Mario just survived a shipwreck.
I also didn't have Goombella.
Wait.
Damn it. Fuck you for throwing stuff at me! I don't care if I wanted it.
I'm guessing that you can't touch them.
No. It's Ember. It's a pale blue flame spirit.
830.
So susceptible to ice or explosion. So I didn't realize until much later that these guys are supposed to be like the fireballs that jump out of the lava and the platformers.
Oh, really?
They were originally called Potaboos, but I guess at some point their name changed to Lava Bubbles.
Potaboo sounds like something that was, Quake Hammer, probably.
They're not on the ground.
It wouldn't affect them, you think?
Nope, right. It wouldn't. Oh, wow, not enough.
You're gonna have to switch out your partner.
Yeah. I wonder if the burn carries over. Nope.
Nope.
Wow, that is early.
Good job!
Huzzah!
Have you adapted?
I don't know yet.
Wait. Oh, damn it. We haven't gotten any one of those.
Nope, not yet.
Like, holy shit, we've never been that unlucky with slots.
Ow.
Oh, he had Doken.
Didn't you say there was, like, a New Japan Pro wrestler who used a Hadouken?
Yeah, Kenny Omega. He, he didn't use it in New Japan, he used it in another promotion called DDT, and sometimes in another promotion called PWG. He just do it a Doken. Like, no effects or nothing, and the other guy would get hit by it.
Yeah.
And
there was... And he was like the big anime nerd guy?
Yeah. No, he's a cool guy, I like him.
Alright, let's go exploring.
Like, for his shit during New Japan's Wrestle Kingdom, He had a video where they just reenacted the Terminator entrance.
Oh,
where he's
yeah.
like, your clothes, give them to me. And everything. He came out with a shotgun and like a leather jacket and half his face was metal. It was great.
Yeah.
He fought Kazuchi Okada in what is the best match of this year, so.
You're charging me?
No, you son of a... You son of a bitch!
You have an in... Okay, fine. Fucking... trying to make a profit in this situation?
Yeah! Survival of the fittest!
You're on a deserted island. Coins mean nothing.
You're trapped in an island, lost at sea. Shipwrecked, you'll cease to be.
Oh no, wait, you can go spend your coins at Toad's shop.
I'll stuck here till the day. Now I'm stuck here till the day I die.
Oh, look, all my items are
here. My stash!
That's convenient.
You got an in coupon in there.
I do, I just used one though.
Yeah. Store some more shit, I guess.
I've got a lot of shit that
keep
I frankly
the blue
don't
sheet,
need.
Get rid of the dry shroom.
Yeah.
And Mr. Softener, I guess. The other stuff could actually be useful. I think it's necessary for there to be vendor trash in games.
Yeah.
Like, because I always feel like in RPGs, there's like so little way to like get like cash. And
you think so?
Well, I mean, it's either you grind or. Well,
yeah.
Also, it's more thematic if rather than you get monsters and drop gold, you can get monsters and like sell their pelts or something.
I guess, yeah.
Got him! Wow, those guys are no threat.
I thought by vendor trash, I thought you meant like items that aren't even worth much selling. They're just kind of in the game to fill slots.
No, vendor trash it specifically should be used to, like, as a method. It should have a use. Something vendors, you can't use it, but vendors can, is the point.
Something that has no purpose other than to sell.
Yeah. Trade goods, basically.
Yeah.
Like, in a game of, in set in the Victorian era, vendor trash would be, like, spices or tea or something.
Yeah. Oh, wow, I'm glad I didn't buy it.
Wow! That's, okay, that...
Items everywhere.
Wow. This island is a trap, huh?
Damn it, through the bush.
Yep. Take out the flower one first.
Yeah. Well, no, I'm gonna take out the one with the item first.
Alright. Oh yeah, that's right, they're no threat.
Nah.
What?
Well, this one can hurt me. The flower one can't.
Oh, well. So much for that.
See?
Oh, that's right. You can recover one. I just realized something.
What?
The monsters, like, the enemies in this game?
Yeah?
They have such low, like, attack and defense ratings, they could feasibly be, like, magic cards.
I guess, because they're single digits?
Yeah. Like, if you bump them up by one, you could actually have some competent creatures.
Can you imagine this game if it had, like, Yu-Gi-Oh! Or MapleStory numbers?
Oh, like,
everything
in the thousands?
Yeah, everything's in thousands and tens of thousands.
Well, do you like that kind of game mechanic if it's like in the thousands, or do you prefer lower numbers?
I don't really care either way. I find
well, then you won't. Then you'll be phased by Super Mario RPG's mechanics.
Yeah.
Then because that they do, they have more traditional like Final Fantasy level like power
damage
levels.
Values, yeah.
Like hits can go up to the hundreds.
All right, so this one can poison us. Great. I love poison. That's my favorite status effect.
Yeah. It's great getting poisoned. Really bringing in the big bucks. Take out that guy first.
The one that I can kill.
Me.
Damn it.
All so much for that.
Fuck you!
Kill him quickly.
Aha!
He's not poisoned!
Next time I'm gonna take Goombella out, she'll still be poisoned. It carries over like Pokemon.
Outside of battle, it ends though.
No! Ah! You idiot!
I have the spike jump badge. I didn't equip it, apparently.
Good thing he wasn't affected by it.
Nope. Cooper's my tank. Note to self.
Rock.
I see it. Note to self, equip the spike badge.
Yeah, please.
Yeah. All right. Also, Pizza Ninja's back. In Jackie Chan.
Yeah. Strike Master Ice.
Yeah.
Jackie Chan even identifies him by name.
He remembered his name. That surprised me.
Strike Master Ice. You? Wow, poison lasts a long time.
Yeah, it said 9 turns. Even the enforcers didn't want to work for Drago.
Yeah, no, that's how pathetic that dude was.
Like, we had Shendu, giant demon dragon monster.
He hangs out in a junkyard!
Even Valmont, the human one, was kind of cool. Yeah, like, he was rich and had a cool suit.
Apparently not cool enough that he didn't try to work for Drago, because he just showed up. And
yeah, but still. Oh, I have power plus.
He showed up, didn't say a word, and Drago was like, nope, we're not running with you.
Doesn't even have lines anymore.
He just walks off. What? No, oh.
All power! Oh, I don't need Lucky Start anymore.
That was pretty cool.
It was kind of cool. We'll see what Spike Shield is necessary.
Happy Heart, not really.
We got 5. I could put another. If I got rid of 1 point, I could put the damage back on.
Now you're gonna need all of those.
Not gonna need.
Maybe Hammer Throw. No. What's Tornado Jump?
It's like Quake Hammer, but for jumping.
Oh.
Damages all midair enemies.
Oh, really?
That means it doesn't work on enemies that aren't in the air.
Okay. Trade off.
I think this is good. Right into it.
No more lucky start. R.I.P. I like that mechanic.
RNG.
Somebody's gonna throw a rock at you. Be careful. No? I guess not. Never mind.
Oh, my partners are gonna be weaker now, though.
Nah, you put a power plus on them.
Oh, you're right. I did. Fuck you guys! Multi-hit.
Yeah. We're just running, just.
I don't have anyone else who can jump on spikes. I really wish there was a spike protection P. That'd be nice.
Yeah. They didn't think that would be necessary, I guess.
This guy, this flower guy, has a habit of getting stuck here every time you enter this map from the left.
He just jumps around like as, like he doesn't care.
He's just happy to be here.
Kill him and like get some EXP.
Yeah, I guess I could.
You could.
One of the handful of programming oversights in this game. There aren't too many really obvious ones. I have something special for you.
Yeah, good job.
Thumbs up.
That was a fuck you if I've ever seen one. Only 1 damage to the other ones though, huh? Alright, you're mowing through them.
No chance, no mercy.
No sympathy.
One more fight.
Yeah.
Oh, that's not. I need the Yosh.
Joshi.
Dragon.
This chapter might take a while.
Yeah, this is gonna be
I forgot how long this is.
I think there's gonna be 2 parts, like the jungle chapter in the first one.
Jungles last a long time.
We'll have the island segment, and then we'll have the cave segment.
Are there a flock of Yoshis here too?
Flocky? No.
No native Yoshis. Yeah, that's for Bobbery when we eventually when he decides to see the error of his ways and join us.
Yeah.
I keep thinking Steam's going off.
Steam?
Yeah, like when you get a message. What?
Oh, right, yeah. I guess I should just keep Coops out as long as these piranha plants are around. Cursed ghosts!
Yep, there's the traitor.
By Blubberly's blotches! I'll keep him busy!
Away with you!
It's funny because Bobbery's actually really good against these enemies. They're weak to explosions, but no, he'll just get his ass kicked.
Yeah, because he doesn't have anybody to tell him to explode.
Yeah. Same thing that Bombette needed.
Yeah.
More TV talk. I know you know who I am, but don't tell Mario! Does that guy have a mental problem?
People breaking the fourth wall.
Yeah, they did that pretty abundantly this chapter.
Little does he know that...
I'm gonna get a coconut.
It's like when you're watching Speed Racer Classic and the narration just won't stop talking about how this is actually Speed Racer's brother.
Yeah.
Just all the time, it's like we know! You don't have to keep telling us. Racer X, who's secretly Speed Racer's brother. That was the joke.
I mean, they just knew that Americans were not used to animated serials. Oh, no one watched. Well, people are, this is the first episode people are watching of it. No matter what episode it is, it's someone's first episode.
Yeah. It's like watching fucking The Blacklist and just like, is Liz Reddington's daughter there? Or like saying Reddington, who is Liz's daughter? Or some other
Reddington
way around,
is
sorry.
Liz's daughter.
Liz, who is Reddington's daughter?
That's some fucked up lineage.
I had a sex change.
Yeah, there's peril going on, but I gotta check the trees first.
There could be items, you don't know. Oh, is he stuck up there?
Nah, he's fine.
For just 12 coins, you can get a full refill on life.
I'm sure that'll be important later. Wait for it.
Ha! Hey, you struck first! Da-da-da-da-da!
Alright, eat this, asshole. Ow!
You!
I did it bad. Oh, I'm gonna level up. Fuck that, then. Art attack!
Oh, that's a new one. How's this work?
Eat Picasso!
Oh, that's actually pretty good. Keep going!
Oh, out of time.
Just...
Yeah, supposedly
Mario repeatedly ripping holes in reality to damage his opponents.
Yeah, it's a really... Possibly the most powerful single-target attack move out of the star moves.
That's right. Alright, badge check.
Sorry,
Bob. Oh, the danger's not over!
Sorry, Bobbery, I'll get... Oh, I did get the ice badge. I should have worn that. I'll
get
to you,
Bobbery. Can you deal increased damage with ice badge?
Yeah, you deal increased damage to fire enemies and can jump on them.
Well, then you can... Oh, no, but you still need spike badge.
Yeah, I do have spike badge on. I have both now.
Good.
Magurush.
No. Let's say Magurush for a second.
Magurush?
Magurush, too.
I wonder if there's any way I could get Power Plus P on. Probably not.
Nah.
I'd have to get rid of some HP or FP, and I'm not quite there yet.
Or, oh.
What do you have?
I'm saying you need to equip that and another 2 level 1 and re-equip Lucky Star, but nah, let's not do that.
Nah. I'll get, I'll take that off next level and put the Power Plus on.
I'm dying!
I'll see my dear Scarlet soon.
I must thank you for taking me out to sea one last time. Get me my Chocola Cola.
Not booze, it's cola.
It was probably booze in the other version. Dudes, that... Never mind, we'll get to that when we get to Super Mario RPG. Because if I'm right, that's not the first time they would have done that.
Yeah.
Kind of, polarization. Now there is it. The localization style.
What about them when they replaced Peach's dildo?
Was that an actual thing?
Yes.
She had a dildo.
In Mario RPG!
Oh, yeah. Are you sure it wasn't her panties?
No. Could have been anything. Do you not know what I'm talking about? If not, we'll get to it.
Sure.
You are still alive. We have some fortune left.
I'm looking for some cola.
Are we still one man short?
That's right. Bobbery sacrificed himself to fight the ghosts.
Well, been trapped on the island for about a week.
Mario, go save.
Let's have an orgy.
But it's all dudes here. Except that one gal in the toad house. Wait.
Like, I will admit that that Family Guy got me with that one bit where the five of them were trapped on an island. They were trying to have an orgy.
Yeah, I remember that.
Then the cruise ship looked at them and called them fanny bandits.
Yeah.
That was...
Alright, so we
then got... Then Peter got home and revealed that his wife married his dog.
Yeah.
If I found that out, that would probably drive me to suicide. Like... you're fucking the dog?!
How would John Wick react to that?
His wife is dead.
He'd have to choose between his wife and his dog. Wait.
No! You're not... You're...
In a world where they were both alive, obviously.
What? Like, his wife is still alive,
and he also
got
a
dog.
Yeah.
I don't want to go down this line of conversation.
I am the editor of Foppish Gourmet Weeklies. So I know my delicacies.
Foppish Gourmet.
I don't think he knows what that means. Alright, here. So he has the cola, but it's part of our shared food supply. So we have to trade for, other food.
There is a coconut.
Yeah, I have a coconut.
It reminds me of fucking American Horror Story. There was literally a fop, and he... Because he lived out in the country enough with, like, just his servants and stuff, he would hit on this black guy a lot. This was, like, in the 1700s.
Okay.
And that wasn't cool.
Define fop.
He wore really fancy, dresses. Like, really fancy, like, torso wear.
Yeah.
And, like, outfits. And he had all these paintings.
So it's like
elegantly.
Aristocratic, dude.
Yeah, but he also talked like really flamboyantly.
Oh.
And he like talking to his like manservant. He's like, and as they're like you know being intimate, he's like, I love my paintings. I love them even more than you. And the guy, other guy, to his credit, didn't seem taken aback by this.
Yeah.
He just like looks at him for a bit like, oh, you.
That's okay. I love your paintings more than you.
Then they talk about it for a little bit, and he's like, all right, before we get out of the bath, let's play with each other's nipples. And that was about it.
Okay.
Or... Oh!
I thought foppish meant like uncouth, like unsophisticated.
No, fop is... Does Nintendo even know? Let me check. What is foppish?
They're not gonna hear it, you're gonna have to read it out.
Of a man, concerned with his clothes and appearance in an affected and excessive way.
So,
synonyms, dandyish, dandified, dapper, dressy.
Metro.
Yes.
Hey.
God damn it, first you're all trying to be black and now you're all trying to be gay.
Did you see that episode?
I didn't. It sounded magical though.
There was an episode where it was like the in thing for everyone. All the guys in South Park, the man and the kids, were all acting metro because that was the in thing now.
Yeah, act like you're gay.
And Mr. Garrison was pissed off because the gay people were losing their identity because everyone was now acting gay.
Oh my god. You're stealing our identity. Stop it. Like, it's like people trying to act like geeks to be cool.
Yeah.
Or the fact that Big Bang Theory exists.
I watch Star Wars. I'm such a nerd.
R2, do you miss fucking?
I played this game called Ocarina of Time. It's obscure. You probably never heard of it. Have your booze.
You don't say, I say as I play down well.
Farewell, Captain Mario.
Alright,
What? Pirates? I didn't even check if he was sleeping, I just whacked him.
Oh, Mario, boy,
the guy just has, like, mild wounds, like, I'm going so long, and he just pretends, like, eh. And the guy just looks, steps up, and just slaps him across the face. You're fine, get up.
Mario, old boy, it's you. You have adventures in the afterlife as well? Capital!
Capital.
So glad to hear you're dead.
You're still alive, you crazy old coot.
Oh, yes, well, really? Is this a tropical paradise for fallen sailors? Alright, you better take me with you.
No choice, whatever, fine. It was still playing for a second there.
Yeah.
Press X to make Bobbery blow up. Imagine that.
Hey, move. You can stop early in this one, right?
Yes, you can choose. You can stop early in the previous one, too.
Good.
It's a little faster now, so their animation for blowing up isn't quite as long. It's also his default move, as opposed to Bombette had the body slam, and the bomb was a special move.
Yeah. Does it cost any FP to explode?
No. It's his default move.
Good!
But I think if you do it from the field, it might be stronger.
Oh, sweet!
So you still get the advantage of field explosions.
So at this point, we're just gonna be using him to just,
initiate?
Yeah.
Maybe. We'll see.
Like, that's a great way to do it in real life. Like, you're being attacked by a bunch of assholes. Like, you just set the claymores down and they can just explode.
Or you set C4 and then chase Revolver Ocelot around with a trigger in your hand.
That's what actually happened.
The best way to fight Revolver Ocelot, not with a revolver.
The boss battle's causing us trouble normally, so we just decided to set C4 down.
And you were like, can that even work? Can you do that?
Yeah.
So I just laid a bunch of it down and started chasing him around the room until he walked over it.
You know what? We gotta get that disc fixed and actually finish the game on stream.
Or just use the ISOs.
Yeah.
Like, we could do... PlayStation ROMs have been working pretty well. We could do that at any time.
Alright.
We wanted to do classic Metal Gear and not wait for Twin Snakes.
Metal Gear? Yeah, we could do that. We should do that. That was fun playing that game.
Yeah.
Which is kind of weird because you were kind of just, you were apprehensive going into it, but you were willing to play it a lot.
It hasn't changed that much. It's not, I didn't particularly enjoy the game, but it's a game.
I can play through it. Stealth games, I'm good at those, I think. Be our lead into Hitman.
We saw a Skull Rock. Well, obviously, there's treasure there. Let's go investigate.
Sure. Yeah, let's do that. Seems legit.
Well, let's have a vote. Should I go with them? Yeah, be off with you. Fuck off. We don't want you here.
My vote counts as 6.
Flavio hates you all. Flavio will join you for a short time. There's a way to glitch this so that Flavio stays with you for the rest of the game.
I know.
I don't know how,
but... The speedrunner did it when they did this game.
Just for fun? Or is there an advantage?
Well, they started with Punio, and as a result, the timer and, like, the Punio, like, the countdown segment for the tree.
Yeah.
It wouldn't stop for the longest time. You just every scene after that was like you could hear ticking. Huh. And it drove people fucking crazy.
For the rest of the game?
No, not for the rest of the game. Like an hour though.
Oh.
That was a long game.
Let's see how much this does.
I mean, this is a long game. And the guy used sequence breaking glitches and it still took like 2.5 hours.
Five.
Oh,
no, it's exactly as strong. Okay, so you just get the default attack in early with Bobbery.
Yeah. Still good to,
It's still powerful, but you're not saving flower points.
Yeah. Do you have defense?
Nope.
Dang it.
Just gonna say it once again, I am so glad that they did the thing where when you get the boots, you do a spin jump every jump.
Yeah. That was kind of, bad. Hey, force your timing to work differently, game.
I'll keep it
that
out.
That was brilliant.
Oh. Because he's good against the fire guys, too, if we run into them.
Yeah.
I guess we won't until we're in the cave, though. You know, we got 2 hours. We might be able to make it through this chapter.
Yeah. Well, we got more than 2 hours. It's, today was a half day for you, and it was a day off for me, so...
Yeah.
We can always go to other stuff, I guess. Wait, what? The fuck was that?
Just water falling. I think that clears any, status effects.
Oh, that's cool. It worked it preactively. Or proactively.
Yeah.
Don't we have, like, the biggest stage now? Like,
biggest
in there?
Stage?
The biggest, like, audience?
No, no.
No? Oh.
Alright, Yoshi. We are a B-list star. There's still, I think, A and S.
We're still starring in B-list films, like The Dividing Hour.
Get off, Flavio.
Mario's a B-lister? Are you serious?
You gotta get the... Luigi's the A-list money. He's the one working out the movie deals. Mario's the one going on adventures.
Yeah.
Nothing weird about this. Just a guy riding another guy, riding a little kid.
It's fucking Spelunky all over again.
A dead end taunting Flavio with its dead endness.
I guess you punched the skull in the eye. Oh, you're just gonna stay there then?
No. Hi, come on. A large stone blocks the way. There's a space where you could conceivably place something. Doesn't Flavio have a gem that might fit in that hole?
Well, yeah, good luck getting him to part with it. You need your skull. Mario's been missing for like over a week.
I want some cola! I already gave you that, you rat. Can I have some money?
You poor larder?
What do you need coins for in a deserted island? Exactly! What's the innkeeper doing?
Your money's no good here.
Give me the gem.
Like, the population they got, they're gonna get inbred really quickly.
Yeah.
If they try to, like, live here.
Yeah. Well, I mean, not that... In a couple generations, none of them are, like, related now, I'm sure.
Yeah, but... I guess they have a good 100 years before they have to worry about stuff like that.
By the way, can we agree that I'm not whacking his belly? This is clearly smashing his face.
Yeah.
What a convoluted door lock this is. Nope, won't work from this side.
Only those who choose may enter. If you choose, then enter.
Only those who can be thrown can enter.
I love that line. I saw that line in this this movie called Alien vs. Predator.
This little movie, probably haven't heard of it.
I like it. I don't know why it's gotten a bad rap.
Has it?
Yeah, unnecessarily so, because it's just another action movie. And in there, they're like in this like ancient pyramid they found in Antarctica, and it has a line, some lines in which...
Oh, so the note comes next. Yeah, okay, it has a line.
There's like, where the guy's reading off like the ancient like scripture, and it's like, if you choose, then enter. And I'm okay. And people are like, wait, so we can just enter? But then the guy is like, no, you're wrong. It's only the chosen ones may enter.
Oh.
Which is like, what could this mean?
If you're chosen, you enter.
Yeah.
Ooh.
You enter.
I'm the scary Tootin' Koopa.
You enter, and then you, you become,
you know what else
would be food for facehuggers.
You know what else we could start in the near future? Donkey Kong.
Speaking of Rare, they're making a new game. Like, they backed out Kickstarter and everything.
Are they down to that level now? They have to back their games?
Well, it's better than going through a developer.
I guess, yeah.
But it's basically the same format as Banjo-Tooie, or Banjo-Kazooie, sorry.
Are you talking about Yooka-Laylee?
Yes.
Okay, that's coming out, isn't it? Is it, like,
this
funded
year.
Everything?
Yeah, this year. It's funded, it's coming out.
I didn't
out.
Know it was Rare, though.
No, it's actual team is Rare. And, like, the same, like, music designers and everything. Which I like. I like the fact that it's coming out. You could care less.
Yeah.
Or you couldn't
I mean,
care.
I'm happy for the Banjo fans. They're getting a... kind of a knockoff of Banjo that doesn't... isn't wrapped up in all the licensing and...
It's a chameleon and a bat, by the way.
Yeah.
SBO and Rouge's Wild Adventure.
So do we want to do that? Do we want to... finish this and do the full stream, or do we want to switch to Donkey Kong?
You want to do Donkey Kong?
Either one.
I it's up to you.
We're already here. Let's finish this.
All right. We'll do Donkey Kong next time. Yeah, you got him.
I hadn't thought of that, mentioning the options we could do today.
Spooky. Oh, no.
It missed.
I guess you can...
And see, it won't work because none of them are on the ground. I can't even try to use it. It won't let me.
Oh! You can use this!
I'll set him on fire!
Some guy, it's like some guy tossing you a shotgun. Yeah. No, you're not going to use it?
This better not be able to miss.
The fog is there. The fog is still there!
The fog. Has that been the title of a horror movie yet?
Yes! Like, some people get lost in a fog, and monsters are coming, and killing them in the fog.
Is it the fog from Avatar?
No.
That's
a pretty
fitting
fog. It's a Stephen King
fog. Damn it. It's fine. Didn't kill him.
Yeah, you did.
Should
have used the fire flower.
Burn! Kill it with fire. And there's a
that's a thing? I forgot that could happen!
I mean, it makes sense, but... no damage.
Fight fire with fire!
Turns out that's a shitty adage.
You know what's why I'm laughing so hard?
What?
I'm like... seeing the fire gun, I'm like thinking, man, it sure would be funny if that ended up healing them. And it did, and it was!
Yeah. Now, I think they want you to do the Vivian through this, but fuck that.
By the way, speaking of Final Fantasy IX again.
Uh-oh! Now these fuckers. Wow, they took a long time in this game for us to get to these guys.
Yeah.
As opposed to the last game, they were in the first dungeon.
So,
Final Fantasy.
In Final Fantasy IX, there was like, there's the aforementioned like giant dude that you can only kill with the Mage Master, and there's this other guy. You got the other guy because he keeps casting Blizzard on the first guy, and that ends up healing him because he's like an ice demon and whatnot.
Yeah.
Are you gonna tattle on them?
Yeah.
Okay.
Stylish tattle. Attacks after being shot from a bell blaster.
Yeah, take care of it or it'll kill you.
Totally wail into you, mosh pit style.
Mosh pit. Mosh, the most brutal style of dancing.
Yeah.
It's literally just people, like, just slamming into each other while death metal goes.
Is it a death metal thing traditionally?
Well, it's high tempo, like, music, right?
I don't know.
It's like it's like really hardcore music that they usually do it to. I witnessed a mosh pit once.
I thought it was just people deciding to go crazy no matter what was playing.
People moshing the
Britney Spears.
Oh, baby, and then something people are just like, yeah, fucking, just rubbing into each other.
Mosh pit.
There would be deaths, because you know what kind of fandom that has?
Yeah.
That or had, in Britney Spears' case?
Hannah Montana.
Yeah, the teeny bopper shit. Like, all the teen girls and baby boys who are, like, accompanying the girls are, like, there, and then suddenly these big dudes with, like, beards run into each other, and then there's deaths.
A jet mosh pit at a Justin Bieber concert.
They knock somebody out while Justin Bieber goes, "Is it too late now to say sorry?" Fuck, you'd have more luck like moshing to like some kind of EDM concert, because at least that's got drums.
Yeah. Did you see the Death Clock episode where Murderface tries to find religion?
Oh, did he?
No. He decided that all religion was the same and went to a bar instead.
Because alcohol is his religion.
Oh. And so they tried to start a mosh pit at a Christian rock concert.
Oh, dude! How'd that go?
Poorly.
God.
I think some random audience member got knocked out and they hurt themselves.
Of course. Oh, I thought that was just one. I think it's 10.
It was a big one. Oh, that was new. We got trumpets. Someone heard this music and decided, you know, this doesn't sound piratey enough.
Indeed. So what's stopping us from leaving? We just don't have a boat?
Yeah. That's it. God forbid we make a raft. Oh, hello.
Hi.
I'm gonna blow you up. This seems like a good idea. Oh, that hurts. Oh, fuck! If I got the health to tank it, that takes them out immediately.
Here you are.
It's a first strike and last strike.
First, last strike only. Alright, you better mess with your badges while you...
Yeah. I've never done that before.
Just take them out, and then another guy goes, explodes, which causes a fucking chain reaction. It's great.
There are no spike enemies in this dungeon, so I'm just gonna do this. Oh, no, I still have two. Okay. I miscalculated. Oh, it takes three, goddammit. Wow, ice power only takes one, spike shield takes... I guess there are more spiky enemies... Is the logic?
Yeah, the more fire enemies. You could go for... Shrink Stomp? No. If it works. Oh, Piercing Arrows.
I'll get rid of it for now.
And then you're gonna go for...
Well... Yeah, sure. I will need the Spike Shield against Cortez, I think. Maybe.
Okay. Well, better be safe, but... Next time you see the big fat ass pink bomb, you better tattle on it.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
This won't fuck up at all. Look, they're hogging all the seats. Dicks.
Can't believe I had to pay for two seats.
pop.
Yay! It's just one guy waving a tiny little flag. Yay!
Yay!
The one who likes the non-action command ones.
Japan.
Japan.
He likes it realistically, not that big long setup that the pro wrestlers do to, for the finisher. Shine spray.
How am I gonna get you? That's how.
Buzzy Beetle.
Come get me. Hello?
But it can fly. Can they fly in the other games?
I think there were parabuzzies in the previous.
Oh no, don't fuck with the first one!
I wonder if it can use items when it's flipped over.
Probably not.
Fire and explosions have no effect, so don't bother.
What, really?
Okay. I thought explosions in the last game, okay, they didn't damage them, but I thought they still flipped them over.
Yeah, you got a reprieve. You better take that first one out soon. Please, 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 please.
Nope.
Damn it!
Not one. Go get him, Goombella.
Yeah, we took out the one with the nuke. The tactical nuke.
You're gonna die. They look so panicked when they're upside down. They get like coke eyes.
Yeah. Oh noes. Earthquake.
Alright, bomber, do your shit.
Turn back!
Turn back, or you will never leave. We're never leaving anyway. What do we got to lose?
Nothing, that's why.
It's either defeat you or become or have my family line become inbred. I don't want that latter one.
Alright, let's tattle. And then we'll blow them the fuck up. I think it's like other ba-bombs, but it's huge! 6-2-1. Weird, it never attacks, but once it fuses lit, it'll blow up on its own eventually.
Okay.
I don't mind it taking itself out, but that hurts us too. Oh, thank you.
Like, oh my god, that bomb is so pink and beautiful.
When it blows
can
up,
can I get a plushie of it, Mario?
That tech
really
power
good.
Is 8, that hurts.
Friends forever.
I just want to cuddle it and squish it again. It's so cuddly and adorable.
Anyway, Mario, you can kill him now. I'm getting bored of him.
I need to offload some items. I wonder if thunder explodes them. Let's find out how earthquake does. I think it does 4 damage, but I'm not positive.
Alright.
I think it replaces the snowman from the last game, because I realized that was stupid.
Okay. I guess just bounce on them.
Yeah, I guess I can.
Good thing you got Goombella.
Yeah. I was considering switching to Koops because his power shell is more reliable than my multi-bounce.
Yeah.
Harmless, defusing complete.
We have successfully ended.
Remember that epic fail of a defusion in Excel Saga?
Well, they either cut the wrong wire
and it
then,
just blew up.
And then the woman was like, I trusted you and this is how you repay me, and then explosion.
And everyone died. Good series, that.
Well, it was a good thing that you got God on your side.
Yeah,
nope.
The great will of the macrocosm.
Why do you and her share the same voice actress?
Shh, that's a spoiler. Excel Saga spoilers. It's a very intense, dramatic series. Wouldn't want to spoil anything.
No, turn back.
He's just desperately trying to get back up. Damn it! Just Nasir walking off the edge to his death.
Dun, 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 dun. So, yeah, never mind. I said I was going to save it from the Lagoon stream. I'll save it.
Okay. I don't know what it is, but
the
you can
difference
save it.
Is between Lagoon.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that'd be more topical there.
Yeah.
By the way, you're welcome to do the Lagoon highlights if you want to. I have no idea when I'll get around to them.
Alright. I'll get started on it. I have an idea of what I'm going to do anyway.
I did the older highlight videos in Movie Maker, so you don't need anything fancy for it.
Alright.
What did we get? We got a key. Sure is a lot of water in this dungeon. I'm sure that's a coincidence.
It's gonna flood. At least it's not lava.
Yeah.
We already had that in the other game.
Bowser's castle with the unhappy cloud riding over the lava.
Yep. Why am I doing this?
Oh. Hello. Get fuck off. I want stars. They're holding it down. They're covering it so I can't do it. Oh, that pulls them to the ground if I do it with them above it.
Wow, that's amazing. Fuck you, game!
Nope. Just gotta time it now.
Good luck.
Yay!
Nice! Full wipe.
Screw you guys.
Only two.
And we're getting somewhat substantial.
It's great how Mario, like one of Mario's lower level ones, is his ability to just, warp the ground to like hit waves at somebody.
Yeah.
And then he's got a better one, which he just punches holes in reality to damage his opponent.
Paper Mario is fucking broken. No wonder he's not in Smash. what would his final Smash be? Like, it would have to be... Would his moves be more... Probably more based off of the Star Spirits from the first game. Or a little more iconic.
Take out the middle one first.
Yeah.
Yeah, the first game. He has, like, a hammer smash, I guess, is, I don't know. Like, his final smash could just be the... Him doing the peach, like the star beam or something.
I guess, yeah. I don't think that's quite up to Final Smash iconography, whatever.
Sweet tree
iconicness.
It summons a bunch of items.
No. It'd have to be a damaging move.
Star rain? No, that's star. We got star storm. Yeah, the one where like you can draw stuff around them.
Yeah.
With the stick.
That'd actually be topical because, you know, Paper Mario, drawings and everything.
Yeah, that would fit. Yeah, that's what we'll do. That's what we'll convince Nintendo to do. Well, that certainly was a thing. Let's continue on.
I guess I realize Mario doesn't have the, Mario doesn't have a ground pound move in Smash, despite him being able to ground pound in many of his games.
Yeah.
Oh, damn it. Jump the gun!
Well, how would a ground pound work? Would that be just the down B?
They gave that to Bowser, so I guess they wouldn't want to, use that too much.
Yeah. You know how much they hate clone characters.
Yeah. Nope. Can't get that yet.
You sure you can just...
Nope. Gonna have to come back later. And I don't mean later this chapter. I mean later after another chapter. I'm gonna have to come all the way back here if I want that shiny
sprite.
Wow.
That sucks.
Hey, come here.
What'd you get?
I don't know.
I still don't know.
It was the red one.
So, get Bobbery to explode again, and then... You are no match for my guerrilla tactics! It's time for warfare.
Come here! No.
Shit! He evaded the
C4! Come here. No. This one's smarter than the others.
It can think. There we go.
Not very much, but it can think. Oh, these ones are stronger.
Face tanked!
time bombs that explode one turn later.
Wow, that is useless!
Maybe it'd be good against
multi-bounce.
Maybe it'd be good against a single enemy.
Multi-bounce.
That's not gonna kill them, though.
No, but then the first one will take enough damage that Bobbery can finish them off, and you'll have two for one rather than just...
Yeah.
Or you can do the spin strike.
I'm just gonna kill them. I'm just gonna kill one of the high hitpoint ones.
Alright.
Oh, he still has one.
Yeah.
Sizzle.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Multi-bounce would have killed the first one and dealt damage the second one. But no, it's better not to burn your flower points. Especially in this dungeon.
It would have been the same end result. Smash it! Nope, okay. Bomb it! Pull it! Twist it!
Pass it.
Nope, I hear that.
Oh no, who is it?
Wait. Huh?
What hits?
Oh, it's just a safe spot, okay. I was wondering if I'd found like a secret technique or something.
Secret technique? You're in the zone of my 8 trigrams.
I guess I could just gulp them.
You can't see me. We haven't seen that move in a while.
Go get him! Yeah!
Yeah!
Fuck the cannons!
Defense what? This is why,
Damn it.
Let's say, this is why Yosh was a co-champion.
Yeah. No sweet spot here. I wonder if there are like, I wonder if Bullet Bill are always worth it. Or, I mean, worthless. Like, even if you came here at level 1 somehow, like, they would still be worth 0 star points.
Well, what's their stats? They're 0 to 0, right? Or they're 2 hit points,
2,
1 attack.
241.
241. Shit.
Like, I wonder if they programmed them to be worth 0 at all times just so that you couldn't grind them. Which would make sense.
Yeah. But you could, because the game's mechanics allow you to get at least 1 star point after every battle.
You wouldn't want to grind them.
I don't know, there's some pretty crazy people out there. No. Oh, you made it!
Got
good.
It.
Got enough for one more gulp attack. Might want to use it.
Ah!
Are you serious?!
Oh, that
would've... That would've killed you dead!
I could've guarded.
You know, you say that... Just being honest.
I want to do it.
You're doing it. As long as you survive.
Give me Marios!
You idiot!
I'm gonna get 0 Mario health. I got 2.
God, you suck!
Fuck it, that's enough!
Are you sure? How much damage do they do again?
2.
Careful. Block.
I'm trying. I don't think you can block it.
1 hit point was. Oh, you. Okay, that's why you weren't so worried. All right.
Oh, I leveled up. That's nice.
Oh, what?
I just wanted to see it happen again.
Oh, I leveled up.
It's because we've attained the meaning of life, the universe, and everything.
All these explosions, I'm surprised the cave doesn't, like, go.
Piercing blow. Actually, I guess I should put on the spikes again.
What's... There's no...
Oh, I did put it back on.
Okay. Yeah, you did... Jeez, man!
Piercing blow.
Do you need it? I guess you do. Charge.
Nah. I guess I could forsake my hammer completely.
Then you need to unequip all the hammer badge stuff.
Yeah.
Because those will be useless.
It only increases it by one, though.
Yeah, that's true.
Kind of wish I could put Lucky Start back on, but don't quite have the FP for that.
Yeah, it seems like.
Yeah, fuck it, I'll have Happy Heart. I blow myself down to one hit point, and then I need to equip my regen.
Except you. Yeah. Bang, ba-bang.
Hello, friend! Oh, P down, D up. Oh, I want the opposite of that. I want more power and less defense. York!
Oh, sweet, sweet salvation. I thought nobody would ever come.
I'd given up. Spare you the prologue and curse you already? Now, how did you know I was gonna do that?
I knew.
Can't you just listen to my spiel for a little bit? I've been locked here forever, bored stiff, doing nothing but practice this speech. I'm the fourth cursing chest you've met? Seriously? You're saying you know exactly how this is all gonna turn out. Man, talk about a raw deal. You're a twisted little guy.
Fine, 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 I get the picture.
All I wanted was to see the face of some unlucky soul when I popped out. Is that so much to ask? Some ghost here has it. Just beat him up and get it, I guess. I don't know why I didn't just
Good job, it. Hero!
I didn't even throw it the right way.
You threw it too late in the wrong direction.
You know what? Yeah!
Good luck with that. That's gonna kill you.
You deserve this, Bobbery.
You're an asshole. Dear fictional dudes. He's still alive.
Oh, come on! What is with pirates and fog?
Look on the bright side. It may miss you.
Point blank and they miss. Oh, it hurts both of us. God damn it. Oh, they have an area of effect.
Yeah.
That's kind of cool, I guess.
My friends! Now you're dead.
Can't believe you can fuck that up and hurt yourself. Explosives are dangerous, kids.
Yeah, don't fuck it. Don't fuck with bombs. Unless, or you'll be in the hospital, posting to a forum, in hospital, lost finger, post more later.
Man, all this time waiting, just get a jaded little creep like you. I decided not to give him the key.
Alright.
Fools! You dopes fell right into my brilliant trap! You've activated my trap card!
Wait, what was next? Oh yeah, your fools will be cursed forever for your bog stability.
You will rue the day you opened this chest of doom!
Now you wretched guy, be cursed. Suffer.
Wait, is that too much? Are you alright? That didn't really hurt, did it? Squirm and suffer like socially awkward worms.
You'll turn into a paper bro boat.
A paper bro.
Paper bro. Dude, bro, Mario.
Hey, Koopella, get drunk with me!
Wow, Mario, you sure have changed since you came to college with me.
But yeah, spring break,
he changes a man.
Yeah, there's apparently a story of a bunch of teens on spring break in Mexico getting into a crowd and yelling at a bunch of Mexicans to build the wall. That's fucking cool.
In Mexico?
Yes! That's equal parts stupid and brave.
Were the Mexicans offended?
I don't know.
Yeah, I get it. You jaded Kurt. Oh, hey, listen, thanks for letting me do my thing. I feel better. I like him. Well, I say, that cursed chap seems rather a bit alright, eh?
Yeah.
I like him.
Now they can be free to go to whatever heaven awaits them.
I like how we're not eaten by the fish here, despite there being nothing protecting us from being eaten by the fish.
Well, paper's unappetizing.
Yeah.
It's like got ink and it's inedible. It's like eating wood.
You say to the guy who eats his fortune cookie fortunes.
If something happens to you from all that, I'm gonna be equal parts sad and I'll go, I told you so.
It's internal bleeding. Paper cut.
You've been doing what? Eating a bunch of fortune cookies? Don't you know that ink causes cancer?
Everything causes cancer.
Just like...
No, I'm staying like this. Oh, curses, my one weakness, a door.
I need hands to take that out.
Mario's cardboard tube adventure.
Did that cardboard tube just do parkour?
I'm very sneaky. The sequel, Cardboard it's like, Mario.
It's like the movie where the fucking, living tire goes around killing people.
Is that a movie?
That is a movie! Like, a friend of mine back in Seattle told me about it. He's like, I'm listening to you going, nah, dude, you're lying, that can't be. Like, no, it really exists! And I looked up the trailer, and sure enough, it does. And I can't remember what it's called, but I'm gonna look it up. Movie about living tire that sets people on fire.
Tired of this shit?
Rubber! That's the name of the movie.
How terrifying. I can't mix curses, by the way. I have to D-tube before I can boat.
Oh, you can't be the water tube?
Nope. What do we got? I remember this being a good badge. Let's see if my memory serves me well.
FN plus.
Nah. I was wrong.
Yeah, you're still from the movie. You thought I was joking.
It follows.
It follows, but with the car tire. A homicidal car tire, discovering it has destructive psionic power, sets its sights on the desert town once a mysterious woman becomes its obsession.
Oh, it's psychic, too. Okay.
I gotta see this movie now.
Yeah, add that to a... Well, no, you usually have, like, Asian films for movie night.
Yeah, I can expand. Yeah, I don't care about your ad. Fuck off.
Oh my god, this ad gets me!
Oh hey, a trailer. Is this the trailer I'm looking for?
The spirit of Twink lives on in Goombella. Is this the same voice?
No. Well, maybe.
For me.
Yep.
This isn't gonna matter if you're not showing it to the stream, you know?
Yeah, that's true.
Can I make it? Am I fast enough? Yes! Cardboard tube OP.
Cardboard tube, fastest.
They see me rolling. Whoops!
I look at speedrunners the same way I look at magic deck builders. It's like they're using cards and manipulating them in expected / unexpected ways to find the best strategy for winning.
Yeah.
You did it, you!
I opened the floodgate.
Ooh, you fucked up.
The ghost must be nearby. Now, I imagine he has like a Sonic voice.
What, the tire?
No.
No.
Yoshi.
Yeah, I gotta go fast, gonna haunt people with my psychic powers.
Look how fast I'm rolling! Radical!
Sonic, except he's cursed to never unroll again. He's
Thank
always,
you!
He's always in ball form.
God. Reminds me of, That reminds me of that episode of Mucha Lucha where the guy Ricochet is, like, just stuck in ball form.
Was that a plot?
Yeah, because his finishing move is, like, he bounces around everywhere. And, like,
yeah, I know that much. I watched the show on and off.
Yeah.
I don't think it would hold up, though.
No. As a person who's very much a fan of pro wrestling, it doesn't hold up.
Didn't he have, a doll that had, like, a stereotypical Hulk Hogan, Randy Savage wrestler voice?
I think so. That would make sense.
Oh no, waves!
I'm sure there's money to be made in, like, a show or something just about pro wrestling, and also pro wrestling is real in that universe.
They did My Dad the Rock Star. They do My Dad the Pro Wrestler.
Oh, you mean Buttercup?
Yeah. I guess that is a thing in Powerpuff Z. The problem is no one watched Powerpuff Z.
People won't watch it because of the implication. Oh! You're still alive!
It's made out of paper! Huge bummer! Well, that was pointless. Well, fuck you guys. I'm not saving you.
Look at me. Look what I can do. You ready for some platforming?
You can't stop me, motherfucker, because I'm on a boat!
Sokka was truly his happiest that day.
Yes. Sokka and his boat hero.
There was a picture of, like, Sokka. He was in, like,
from
a
boat Avatar, the last one.
Yeah, Avenger. And he was, like, in a boat outfit, and there was just a bunch of, like, women with him.
And dudes. And he had dudes. Aang and the crew with him.
Yeah, they were all, like...
Everyone but Sokka was naked and just doing sex stuff.
Yep. Can't stop me, motherfucker, because I'm on a boat.
International waters, yo.
Love to see somebody just try to start a city in international waters.
Yeah.
Like a floating island. Like an artificial island. Like people keep talking about they'll totally do one day, seriously.
That's in Sun and Moon.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Well, but that's an Alohan island. I'm talking about like a person trying to form a sovereign nation.
Yeah, that's in Alola.
Really?
There's a man-made independent island in Alola, separate from the actual physical ones.
Oh, that's interesting. What's it called?
The Aether Foundation. Or
Wait, what?
Aether Paradise, I think, is the name of the island.
Aether Paradise? They harbor planeswalkers?
It's just it's a name of a group who are, like, supposedly environmentalists for Pokemon.
Environmentalists?
They're the anti-Team Skull, Team Rocket.
Okay.
You know, the anti-thugs. The big goods.
If you will.
Of the storyline.
So they're not secretly evil?
So Mario.
So they are secretly evil, gotcha. I wouldn't be surprised either way, because it's like fucking Silphco and Team Rocket, and they were like in bed with each other in the first game, so...
No. Rocket forcibly attacked and took over Silphco.
They were in bed together, shut up!
Oh, okay. Did Silphco supposedly design the, the Mewtwo armor?
That's based off of Silphco tech.
Yeah.
And the founder, Tony Silph, was like, I don't want my technology used this way, and he formed Iron Mew.
Yeah. It's me, Don Pianta's daughter, Francesca, and Frankie's here too!
What? Oh, you guys, you fucks got kidnapped?
After my dad forgave us, we set out on a trip. The ship we were on got a little too close to this island, and now look at us!
The rumors about Cortez were all true.
Hey, so by the way, why are you here, sweetie?
Good thing you left when the Punisher was in town, I guess.
Yeah? Does he punish mob kids?
He punishes everyone. Oh. Like
hence
criminals.
The name.
Like if you're involved in criminal activity at all, especially in the Mac stuff, he just kills you.
Yeah.
Like, he was wasting a bunch of, like, black street kids and a bunch of Russian, like, white supremacist dudes who happen to be, like, doing business with each other.
Yeah.
Figure that one out. And he killed them all, and he finds the last guy who was, like, shot with like a gun, he turns to him, points his gun at him, and says, "They put the sights on top for a reason," and then kills him.
And then he turns to the camera and shoots the viewer. Then he puts the gun to his head and shoots himself.
Everyone will be punished.
God.
Oh, so you followed us in. I'm sure the Crystal Star is on that ship, and Cortez the Big Bad Pirate's there too.
Yeah, you seem to completely trustworthy random pirate. Oh, so you know what Yooka-Laylee's version of Bottles is?
I think he has a name. I think he's called Four Eyes. Yeah, that's the crew's nickname for him. Wait, Bottles? Were there Bottles in Banjo-Kazooie?
No, the Mole.
Oh, the Mole. What's their version?
Is
it a hedgehog? Groundhog?
No, it's a snake.
Oh, okay.
And his name is Trouser.
Okay. They're getting bold, huh?
They're independent.
After Conquer, they stop giving all.
Also, the official name on the box for the development team is Team 17.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah, so I guess Team 17 was like the Banjo was like spinoff of Rare or whatever. I don't know.
No, they're not. Team 17 are the makers of Worms.
Yeah,
they're not. They have nothing to do with Rare. They must be collaborating.
Well, the people in certain companies can leave to other companies.
They can, but they wouldn't. Like, Team 17, you said, was on the product in some form, right?
Yeah, but the Banjo-Kazooie guys are explicitly stated as also working on it. Not Rare, but the Banjo-Kazooie guys.
Oh, so it's not a Rare
game.
It's just the guys who worked on the Banjo-Kazooie.
No, Rare currently is Microsoft's slave.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, by the way, Skull.
Yeah.
I am not a spooky ghost, I'm a pirate!
You are a ghost.
Oh, I missed some good dialogue. He has some good dialogue. Oh, well.
I'll turn your mustache into a bone polisher, amigo. Yo!
All right. Pirate time.
Nice. I'm sure he's Spanish, not Mexican.
Yeah, they were Spanish. I'm saying they killed Mexicans.
What? Who?
The Spanish pirates that came to Mexico killed a bunch of native Mexicans.
When were you talking about this?
My God, you don't retain anything.
I guess not.
He's the dreaded pirate spirit who
haunts
the island.
Like when you were first talking about Cortez, he's an actual guy that existed.
I know.
And he killed a bunch of native Mexicans and stole their gold.
Okay.
Although it could have also been Brazilians. Aztecs and Mayans.
They thought he was a god.
Yeah.
Also, can we agree that this is the scariest looking enemy in the game?
Yeah, that's pretty terrifying.
Like, for a Paper Mario model. Also, this sick, this is like some Team 17 backbeat, the wave synth going on.
DJ Aelita really, putting in the work.
That's 8 damage.
Wow! This guy is actually pretty pathetic if you're dealing that much damage to him. I'm sure this won't be the final form.
Bonk. Of course there'd be skeletons in the audience.
Yeah.
Rooting for Mario, obviously.
So, I was right! You got on the boat, a skeleton popped out!
God damn it. Well, no, we popped in on the skeleton. The skeleton was on the boat, and a Mario popped out.
Rattle me bones!
Nah, fuck this. Actually, nah, never mind. I remember his next form, so I'm gonna save.
Then a skeleton popped out.
I'm gonna save my star points.
Makes sense. Just keep hitting them, and then he'll go down.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that won't matter because I'm gonna kill you. Again, I'm gonna re-kill you. Have you seen the, did you see the Super Mario Undertale Dorkly bit?
Oh, yeah, I did.
Actually,
stomped on his brother. He's like, any second now, he'll come back any second. The biggest, like, frowny face.
I jump on the skeleton Goombas all the time.
Are you doing it?
Yep, I was saving it for this. I guess I could have Earth Tremored. Taking these schmucks out. Yeah, I think that would have been more effective here.
Yeah. Oh well. I'll take him out. Plus dimensional smash. It's the best move.
It's not as effective against big targets because you have to trace the whole body.
Yeah, that's true.
So it's a matter of volume, not
But you took out his weapons, so
I can't take much more of this. This calls for something special. You see the true might of my spirit form.
No, you ate the crowd.
You monster. My fans. Oh, some immediately came back. They saw the rest of the crowd get eaten. And
free seats, everyone! Get the fuck in!
No more standing room only. It's like at the Dark Tournament when Toguro starts eating people and imagine more people flooded into the stadium at that point.
Yeah, because there's free seats.
Everyone was terrified. They were all leaving. The demons were fucking off. It'd be great if there were just some badass holdouts coming in at that point.
I find it great that Toguro's final form was apparently so powerful that being around him will cause you to get eaten.
Yes.
Just...
It's 120%, according to the Japanese version.
Damn it. Would have been perfect time to, finish it anyway. Oh no, the weapons are appearing. The weapons have appeared.
Doesn't matter.
Just kill them.
Stylishly. With manly gusto.
You done yet, buddy?
Oh, that was it. I thought...
Wait! Holy shit, that's great!
Double star points? See, we don't need lucky star. We have the curse effect.
Yeah.
62.
Not quite.
I actually thought he had another form after that. My treasure! I can't really do Spanish or Mexican.
Not after me, lucky charms.
That was neither of those things. You know, the Mexican leprechauns.
You are foolish, amigo.
I can't do it either.
For I am not dead. Well, technically I was already dead, but my spirit endures, tied to my treasure.
Mexican text-to-speech. Mexican text-to-speech. Thank you, Google.
You are not even in-
Mexican text-to-speech! Podcast, here we go.
I can do Cheech Marin, I'll just do that. You want this, amigo? This little rock over here?
Yes, I would.
Alright, give me the gem. Well, that's no big deal. Here, take it. What do I need one or two extra gems for? I didn't even like that one. Looks stupid.
Yeah! So, no, this chapter can't be over because you still got the other fuck just waiting to do something.
Nah, I'm sure he'll just, he'll peaceably see that we got the Crystal Star fair and square.
Yeah,
and,
he'll just leave.
Yeah, he'll just leave.
Cortez, Scourge of the Seas, Mario soundly defeated this fearful spirit and claimed the Crystal Star. Perhaps the peaceful citizens of the world no longer need fear Cortez and his fell ship.
Speak in Spanish?
Yes. I'll translate it someday. I was thinking about the other day about taking Star Wars and changing the setting from sci-fi to crime,
yeah,
and calling it Drug Wars and seeing what would be different.
If you don't need anything, fuck off.
Bye, Cortez. Thank you. Like R2, rather than being just a robot, is just a short Mexican dude who, rather than beeping and whistling, always speaks in really fast Spanish.
Yeah.
And he's a really good hacker. He's like Raimundo Diaz or something.
Yeah.
You know, R2D.
Just got kicked out of the back of the ship.
Why are you? Oh yeah, that's right. We rescued you. Never mind. You guys can go now.
Now that you got some free time, why don't you get us out of here? Demanding much?
You fucking assholes.
How are we gonna break through solid rock? Well, there's only one person who can deal with this.
That works, that'd be great.
He just body slams it.
Say, that gives me an idea. And then a dragon comes and kills everyone. That's how, there was a flash called, like, I think you showed this to me, the Adventures of the... No, it was somebody else. It was, like, the world's worst boyfriend.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, come on. And then he's, like, wanting to sneak into his girlfriend's house. Sees a pizza man out front. And he's like, say, this gives me an idea. And it cuts to the girlfriend in her house, and then a dragon appears, like, through the window and starts yelling, and he's just on it with this evil grin.
When all else fails, summon a dragon.
Sarkon full strats.
I didn't know what to do stranded in that cave, but the whole thing was rather exciting.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just glad my little dame is safe and sound.
Oh,
who am I supposed to talk to? Where am I going? Oh, just down.
Hey, Flavio, you want some treasure?
How's our little expedition faring?
We got what we came for.
The spirit of Cortez was guarding the treasure? And you beat him, but you left all the treasure there? Ah! What were you thinking?
Ah, whatever. I don't care.
Could it be? Brother?
Dude, they've got a breeding population now.
Because there's two brothers? Do you want this island to be inbred? Is that your
game? No! I'm saying they won't be! They can live here without worries of that!
Because of all the guys in the back.
There's some girls there, I imagine.
Ah, Toads are
I'm just saying they've got genetic diversity now.
Toads are asexual anyway. According to Miyamoto.
Alright, true that. Then what the fuck is Toadette doing?
A choice, I guess. It is how they choose to identify. Toads reproduce by budding. It's a warship!
Oh, the Diaz knots are decking.
So sorry to surprise you.
No.
Good job getting the crystal star for me!
Hey, Four Eyes! It's dangerous up there!
Oh, I thought it was like going to be an explosion, then he's in his regular uniform.
Yeah.
I'm actually...
Da-da-da-da!
I am Crump!
I was the mastermind in the shadows.
I'll just keep bombing the island where no one's at.
Drunk at an island, lost at sea, shipwrecked you'll cease to be.
What was that song that went over all the ways that people died? Was that Swashbuckled?
Oh yeah, I think so. Then there was a... What was it? There was one where it was like... Oh yeah, the sea shanty, I'm a broken man on Halifax
Beach. Yeah, Barrett's Privateers.
The last of Barrett's Privateers, yeah.
So we only have one hope. We need to get Cortez...
So he's just shelling the island randomly?
Yes. We need to get Cortez to let us use his ship to combat the warship.
We need your ship, Cortez.
You know that guy whose ass we just kicked?
Yeah. Well, if he doesn't, like, comply, you could just kick his ass again.
Yeah. And also, this is his problem because some asshole is, like, shaking his cave. It's gonna keep him up at night. Hey, bro, we're back.
What?
Is this you again? Did you forget something?
Cortez! I have to speak to you.
Could you lend me your ship?
What?
And who are you anyway?
My name is Flavio. We are in big trouble and we could really use your ship. The bad pirates that are blasting us to bits, so we just need to borrow it for the teensiest little while.
What are you talking about? I do not rent this ship for pleasure cruises.
This ship is magical and it cannot move now.
Why not?
The key to powering the ship is the mystical skull gem.
The skull gem?
You mean this?
You mean this?
You! Take the gem handed down through generations of my family. I think that is a pretty fair deal, do you not, old friend? Old friend! Your ancestors stole that gem from me, you strutting peacock! Very brave and very, very foolish to ask that of me. My Cheech Marin voice is just Spanish Kurosuchi.
Kurosuchi's Mexican cousin.
Yeah, Cheech Marin. You rattle my bones, Senor Peacock.
They were telling you by the time John Cena was, like, fake fired in WWE, he came back as Juan Cena.
Oh, okay, no.
John Cena's Mexican cousin is literally just him in a lucha mask. He came out to, like, a Mexican rendition of his theme.
There's a lucha character in Sun and Moon.
Oh, is there?
Yeah.
Is he a gym leader? Sorry, not gym leader. They don't exist there. Is he a trial captain?
No.
Dang it. Well, what is he? Is he a skull?
No. He's a good guy.
Awesome. Oh. Team Skull go here, they're like, MY LORD!
This is Cortez's room, alright. I guess you'd call this the captain's cabin.
Can you get rid of these Pokemon thieves for me? Their worshipping is very distracting. Yo! We got Cortez on our back!
Pokemon themes?
Yeah. Skull. Team Skull.
Oh, right, yeah.
Pokemon thieves.
Thieves, yeah.
Because they steal Pokemon!
I was reading what Goombella was saying about she wanted to pocket some of the treasure for
science.
For archaeology.
Who wouldn't? Treasures. They're priceless.
You think Jackie Chan and Goombella would get along?
I mean, her appearance would be off-putting for a bit to Jackie, but I'm sure he'd cope.
They just sit down and talk about archaeology.
Yeah. So what did you do? Oh, I gathered crystal stars in order to open a door to combat a demon. What did you do? Oh, well, I collected a bunch of talismans that have magic powers. I recollected magical spirit animal powers after they got scattered.
Oh, and then I
closed a bunch of demons, demon portals.
I opened a door that summons a demon.
Did he?
The portals.
Oh, yeah.
The demon portals.
He did once to get Jade out.
You fire cannons here without my permission? You have nerve, mortal!
Oh no!
What the?
I love this cutscene!
Ghost ship!
Pirate or ship battleship showdown.
The Black Pearl rises again. I'm gonna sink this ghost ship
to the bottom of the ocean. Take that ship and show them the meaning of fear!
I guess the Embers and the X-Knots are kind of well-matched, and then there's like, X-Knots have like 4 hit points and 2 attack power. Although,
yeah.
I would assume they couldn't jump on the fireballs, so.
Yeah, it seems like, what?!
I'm gonna turn you into seaweed!
Oh no, he's got...
Who's this guy? I don't know him. What's your book say? You have an entry on every person ever on the face of the earth?
Not this guy again. 33-0.
He just attacks normally, so don't worry much about him. But those X-Knots all around him are forced to be reckoned with. He can attack us with all kinds of weird moves. I can just
so
feel
take out the X-Knots first. Oh, don't.
Nah, Crump's the one who, if you take out them, they're all just different kinds will show up.
Alright. Fucking. You feel confident in it?
Nope.
Oh, it's pretty good, kid.
Ow.
Multi splash. Ah, you!
The most incompetent leader with the most competent goons.
Yeah.
It's Drago all over again. Ah, fine.
It's Jackie Chan Adventures all over again.
You guys are worth one head bonk. I guess I could have tattled on him just to see the entry, but whatever.
Nah, you already had their entry, I guess. Dude, spin jump is consistently safer and more damaging.
Yeah.
It's weird.
This is kind of easy with all of the power-up badges.
Yeah. Alright! Oh no!
Can they miss? Yep, okay. Works out for me. And fog goes away. Aw, damn it.
Yeah, better break out the star move.
Yes, I could.
Well, that won't deal.
What do you got to say about the ceiling, X-Knots? Miss!
Just an X-Knot.
X-Knot platoon. Crump commands them all. Where'd they come from? Depends on their condition, but attack is 5 and defense is 0. Coordinated group maneuvers. But they're pretty wimpy, so we should be able to handle it, don't you think?
That's cool. What items you got?
Thunder Rage. Fuck it. Earthquake!
Will that affect them too?
Yep. It missed! How's that miss?
It missed. That fog can fuck off right now. Thank you! Alright, I guess do what you're gonna do.
Yeah.
He's almost dead.
I was seeing if I had a hammer throw or something, but I got.
You fucked off! Oh. Wait, what? You just take a bunch of drugs?
I guess it would have been too easy otherwise.
Man, this is no good!
I almost thought it was eight. Almost aced? Aced?
I guess so.
Do you know what that means? You're Japanese! Writers, you should know what that means!
Beaten?
Ace. Ace is like, I'm the best of the best.
I was almost aced. With a T. Someone aced me. Someone beat me.
It's a D.
Yeah.
Not T.
That's why I tried to say D. It was a little too forceful, so it came out as T.
I would think acing me would mean like, oh, you've been promoted.
Yeah.
I'm glad that those guys are nice enough to allow you to wade through them.
Yeah.
Oh no!
Katamari attack! Oh fuck, that hurts.
Yeah.
Still incompetent.
Above the fact he's trying to do the leg drop over and over.
And failing every time. He himself has not damaged me once. Fuck it. I'm never gonna use these items otherwise. Drop these fuckers. Keep trying. Maybe one day, man.
You just took out an entire squad of the- Oh, they're back.
Alright. You asked for it.
Just take out Crump.
Yeah. That's the plan.
Your small body is good.
What? Dimensional hit! Dimensional hit!
Oh, punch wow, there's a lot of lag. It's like, it's taking so long because there's just so much shit on the screen.
One more hit. Is that good? I love the Mario punching through dimensions, like, move.
Yeah.
Just keeps hitting him over and over, and then you see reality breaking every time.
Dimensional sword.
Hey, you gotta level up.
With every defeat, I grow stronger, Crump.
Oh, so he's a Saiyan.
Yeah. Well, no, with every Crump defeat.
Man, this is getting old. How can I lose?
I hate losing.
What?
I gotta think of another excuse for Grotus.
I can't believe they allowed themselves to retreat. They allowed them to retreat, like, really?
Well, I mean, they had to beat up Mario to get the Crystal Star. He's the one who has it.
Yeah, that's true. Well, that's the end of that chapter.
Do we stop now and do the Peach stuff next? Well, no, I want to get through the Peach stuff. I want to get back to Rogueport before
right.
We stop.
In that case, let me use the restroom and I'll be right back.
Okay, there's not much of it.
I really gotta go.
Alright.
The boat's been sunk! Oh wait, no it hasn't, you just retreated.
You blew it again, Lord Crump.
You will be punished.
I thought we had the guy cornered, but stop talking. Stand by until my next order.
I don't remember what voice I gave Grotus.
What is it, sir?
Tell the Shadow Sirens to attack again.
Hey, you got it, sir.
I must take some measures.
All right, peach stuff. What do you got for me? She doesn't look happy. She looks very upset. She looks very tsundere. Oh, dangerous. I must request that you do something more dangerous this time.
Oh no, why?
I would like you to sneak into Sir Grotus's room and take a data disk.
And take a what?
A data disk.
Oh.
Remember when those
I
were
thought you should take a dab of his. Like, he's, like, I want you to go into Grotus's room and get baked.
Remember those floppy disks?
Oh yeah, that's right. This is 2003. We're on CDs now.
Yeah.
Whenever I refer to games like these, I just like when they're made is important, and only because just like they use technology that was outdated by the 90s.
Yeah. Like you have the future world of Dragon Ball where they've got capsule technology to store vast quantities of items in pocket spaces, but they're still on CDs.
Like, just now, it's taken till this decade for USB sticks to become, like, popular in media.
Yeah.
Because the 2000s, we were still, we gotta get the disc, we gotta get the disc. We gotta upload the virus to the oh, it's the fucking cake making.
The baking, yeah. A potion that makes me invisible? You'll enter Sir Grotus' room by becoming completely invisible.
How do you fuck this up? Will you die in game?
And naked. Okay.
It only affects the body. You have to take your clothes off.
I do not know which potion to set where. There should be memos. So there's some puzzle aspect to this. It's a little more in-depth than the place.
That's why you
want to
get through this.
Place two potions between the green and the red. So the green and red are on the outsides.
Okay.
Blue potion next to the red. Do not place the red on the far right. So the red's on the left.
Very interesting mechanic.
Green's over here. And I think it said the blue's next to the green.
Yeah.
Next to the red.
Blue next to the red. Which only leaves...
The orange one goes over here. No? Okay, I guess it goes here.
What's that alarm? We should investigate it. No? Okay.
Press it where it stops. And not while it's moving. That would be silly.
Yeah. Cause then you'll get potion everywhere. Wait!
Like that.
What?
What?
This is going back and forth.
Well, they need to be mixed in a very specific order.
Oh.
It's like a drink where you have to add gin, then tonic, then gin again.
Is that even a thing?
I don't know.
I want gin, I want tonic, and then I want gin again. I guess it's like a pizza where you put mozzarella on, put the toppings, and then put more mozzarella on top to kind of hold it together.
Yeah. 30 seconds. Just sit back, let the music wash over you. Alright, yeah, that.
It's green. You've successfully crafted absinthe. Good for you.
Yay, let's take it. Should be finished, but did it come out correctly? Yes, Twink, it's fine.
Twink, why
do you call me that?
Twink. Sorry,
it smells really funky.
Just a memory I've had. It worked!
You're invisible! But wait, there's a problem. You have to take off your dress.
God damn it.
Please take off your dress. I promise not to use my heat vision.
I love how we're just making him sound like Wall-E. Or...
Actually, that was a little more super comic.
Or Johnny Five from... from Short Circuit.
That was it.
There's a movie called Shopping Mall, and it's literally just a bunch of teens get trapped in a mall with security robots.
I never thought I'd be able to play a game as Naked Peach.
Welcome to 2003.
Except she... Her feet still sound like high heels. She must have some nasty calluses.
I don't know. Maybe that's the sound of, like, meat slapping on the floor.
Okay.
Just flesh. So, this game is the reason why you...
This X-Not scientist is walking into me and not knowing why he has to stop.
What?
Reaches in front of him and squeezes.
What is this? That's so fucked, man.
Wait for
it. Why do you cast a shadow?
Huh? Oh. Those little details that make it.
Yeah.
What were you about to say about whatever you're about to say?
Never mind.
Okay.
Wow, he's got a fucking aquarium like an evil villain.
Yep. It is a nice looking office. Look at that plush, that shag.
Oh, he's trying to get access. Tech's trying to get access to the internet.
Da 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 da.
Well, I forget, that's so cool!
I forget what game this is it's showing. It's the title menu from some old Nintendo game.
Looks like Balloon?
No.
No. Ice Climbers?
Like Captain something.
Captain Skyhawk.
No.
He's a random ass Captain Skyhawk reference.
Peach, apparently techno-savvy. Or at least knows how to use a computer.
Yeah! I mean, being a royal, you have to know how to use technology.
Can you imagine a Paper Mario game where Peach was the home base? Like, you talk to her on a regular
basis. She's got the codec shit going
like,
on?
You have in Paper Mario 1, she was your source of information because she was spying on the Koopas with Twink.
Yeah.
In this game, she's your source of information with Tech. Why can't she just be Otacon? Like, sitting in her castle on a computer.
Dude, a game begins with Mario in, a slightly red, sneaking suit, like burgundy, and he gets out, and then Peach's contacts is like, you have to get in and stop Bowser's plans from happening. He's become a nuclear country.
Yeah, sure.
Or he's like a nuclear power.
Just drink your green potion, you'll turn back instantly. Okay, just 1 minute first. Have to do that?
Yeah.
It's just us in here. Just us girls.
Is game rated E or T?
E.
Okay. Good. Now we must return back to the
computer room!
Peach is more successful sneaking here than she is in, Bowser's castle. She never, got through once.
No, she didn't get to the Bowser door.
Because it seems like Bowser knew how to handle her.
These guys don't! With a door lock. But no, everything has to be computerized here.
Yeah, the AI managed to fall in love with her.
Grotus never thought he could create a computer that could love.
What are you saying? Your computer's become self-aware, and it's learned how to love.
I impress even myself.
But this is a problem, I agree. I mean, Eggman created robots that were able to, feel emotion.
Yeah.
So, and they're apparently his best friends. That's all he wants.
Except Gamma, who had to go on a manhunt for his brothers and then kill himself.
God! Darkest, story in Sonic.
Yeah. The girl who got Sonic AIDS and may have been raped is also pretty bad.
What?
No,
where is that coming from?
That's just a fan theory.
No! That fan theory! Good! Don't that need to add rape to the Sonic universe? That's a bad idea. That's just...
She was gunned down violently, though.
Yeah. That's better, though.
Okay.
According to American society.
Meanwhile...
Where the fuck... Place is depressing. He got lost and he's now in Dark Souls.
The light's on because this is Twilight Town, my lord.
Should be treasure here. Let's put the screws to one of these creepy things.
Oh, hey, it's Crump! Why is he here?
Car!
Whoa, they sound terrified.
Just yep. A bad dream.
Yep, this isn't happening.
It's gonna wake up any second.
Just talk to him, just talk to all of them. Crystal Star? I have no idea.
Please spare me.
Am I going to be turned into a pig again?
How do you come to that conclusion?
You think Bowser has the ability to do that?
What if you just went like kung fu on Bowser's ass, like the wife and the Scotsman's wife?
Oh man, that'd be cool.
So most of them just seem to be emitting fear noises.
Yeah, as Bowser, he has that effect on people.
Sup?
Yep. Now let's
can't
see.
Leave. Also can't fit through doors. Right, and Bowser leaves a heart life.
Just opens the door, Bowser's head peeks through. Hello? Oh, man.
I'm pretty sure Beldum said she lost her super ba-bomb. So he failed like 3 times and now he's been demoted for looking for the broken ba-bomb.
We can salvage it. This sucks.
I had to cowboy up and make a serious comeback or else. Having trouble in the ranks, orange boy.
Bam. Got it.
Luck of the Moon is still riding shotgun with me.
You there, suspicious guy. Witch doctor.
What's the big idea, turtle boy?
Wow, what an idiot. You're dealing with Bowser.
What a confrontation. The battle royale that we always needed.
Crump, stop kissing your boyfriend. I can hear it from here.
It sounds like... Troops are
wow! Bad. Wow, he's outnumbered now.
Kind of a lot of dudes, huh? Unimpressed. Koopa Clan!
We've got army too. Wow! So this random ass town is the site of a battle between fucking, like, aristocratic army versus... fucking space pirates.
All the Koopas here are way stronger than the X-Knots, by the way.
Yeah, I imagine.
Like, I remember Hammer Bros from the first game. Those guys were a fucking menace.
Yeah. Because he actually trained his troops, right?
Weren't they also the only ones to beat us in Glitzville with a hammer team?
Oh, were they?
I think so.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Oh, no! Huh? That was it?
Ah! It didn't even go off! This is how you do it, amateur!
Uh-oh.
I see he subscribes to the same method I used to deal with pink ba-bombs.
And that's... thus ends the story of Twilight Town, destroyed in a giant explosion!
We go through the pipe and the pipe rejects us. Not because of any name issue, because there's no pipe for it to go to. They pop out the other side.
Twilight Town has been marked, like, wiped off the face of the earth. And yet Bowser survives that.
They pop out the other side.
My God. You really did it. You blew it up! You Koopa bastards!
Statue of Bowser's there. However the fuck Planet Apes is. It gets a bit hazy after a while.
Yeah.
No, I'm talking about the original one, not the remake.
I know. I think the remakes are like a trilogy. Aren't they putting the third out now?
No, so there's the first remake, which had Mark Wahlberg and went nowhere.
Yeah.
That ended with him arriving on Earth, and it was like modern day Earth, but they were all monkeys.
And then there was Rise of the Planet of the Apes.
Yeah, that was the one where it was like done more realistically. Like, they just had monkeys just kill people.
But I think there's a third one that either very recently
Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. That's a sequel to that one. Oh. And it's like, society's fallen, and these monkey creatures are living in tenuous peace with humans, question mark?
Wouldn't Dawn come before Rise, logically?
I don't know. Shouldn't Dawn of the Dead come before,
Dead Rising?
For Night of the Living Dead?
I I guess. Not necessarily.
Okay, yeah, you're right, because Night of Living Dead Dawn. Then there was Day of the Dead, which I actually really liked.
Dia et la Morte? I forgot the middle part.
Day of the Dead. That was the one where the world was long since ended, and it was just a bunch of scientists trying to either find the cure or learn how to tame them. And
yeah.
the general who ran it was like an asshole.
Okay.
Well, we got a bunch of migrants. Oh, all of you have been declared dead.
Yeah.
That's
good
a problem.
Good luck dealing with that bureaucracy. Be some fun red tape. They're all gonna go home and find their wives have married their dogs.
Brian, how could you? It's okay, I didn't even have sex with her yet. So Cortez is just gonna chill in this harbor from now on?
Yep, he's mellowed out.
Nice.
Guess we should go to the door. Alright, we're gonna save. Oh.
Oh, wait.
Damn you, Peach.
I have good news!
There's an odd computer called Tech here. I managed to obtain some of these fiends' data. Tech is currently analyzing it, and strange as it may sound, I trust him.
He's done a lot for me.
Once his analysis is done, I should be able to provide you with details of their plans, Snake.
Snake.
I'll email you again once I learn more. Be good, okay?
Be good.
But what does it taste like?
And with that, we're done.
The guy doesn't say, but I imagine it's a hearty meal.
Yeah.
All right, we'll see you.
Next time.
What's
I
the next chapter? That one is.
Next chapter is number 6. The train.
The train.
Oh yeah, that's the one that has an instant game over if you fuck up.
Oh yeah, yeah. At one point.
Yeah, we'll show that off when we get there.
So see you then, folks.
See you then.